After watching this video, you are guaranteed to learn how to solve a Rubik's cube. Here we go. To begin, let's look at this puzzle. The cube consists of parts of several types. The centers, there are six of them, they are in the middle of each side. The point is that no matter what sides we turn, the position of the centers remains still. There are also 12 edges. They have two colors on each part, and here they are. There are also 8 corners. Each has 3 colors. By their name, it's easy to understand that they are on the corners of the cube, and there are 8 of them. There are 6 faces, and each of them can be rotated clockwise and counterclockwise. Each move has its name. But for your convenience, we also prepared pictures. For clarity. Try turning your Rubik's Cube with me. Top face, clockwise, and then counterclockwise. Front face, which is in front of you, clockwise, and counterclockwise. Right face, with your right hand, clockwise and counterclockwise. And the left side, clockwise and back. We don't need any other movements. The first stage is the cross. We need to start solving Rubik's Cube from the white cross, which looks like this. Note that it consists only of edges. We ignore corners at this stage. The correct cross will be when all 4 edges are the same color as the center. For example, the blue-white edge coincides with the blue and white center. Red and white coincides with red and white center, and so on. Let's start. Find a white center on a scrambled cube. This is the edge, another edge, corner and center. And our job is to keep the white up. Don't rotate the cube. If you need to rotate it, do it this way. White should always look up. Accordingly, on this cube, the white is here. It's pointing up. Now we have to find the white edges. They could be anywhere on the cube. For example, on the top face near the white, or on the bottom, where they are not immediately seen, but most often they are on the sides in front of you. And they can be on any of the layers. On the first, second, or third. And our task is to put each of these edges near the white center. For example, we have such a situation. I want to repeat once again that the edges may be anywhere on the cube. But we start with the ones on top, next to the white center. You don't even need to do anything with them. They are already standing in the right place. Let's go to the edges, which are on the second layer. And you can find them by rotating the cube like this. For example, I have this kind of edge. This is what I call a good edge, because it is easy to put it up in just one move. That's how it works. Keep looking for the same edges. Here, for example, there is also an edge in a good position, but on the left side. In this case, we can also raise it up with the left hand in one move. Let's look at this situation. We find an edge in a good position. We are ready to put it up, but as you can see, there is no room for it, because there is already a white edge there. A common situation. If we put it up, the situation on top will not change. So, first we need to make room for our good edge. To do this, turn the top face of the cube until it is free. And then put a good edge up. Consider the situation again. For example, when a good edge is on the left. We can't put it up there, because the place is reserved here. So we turn our top face until there is room for our good edge. Now you know what to do with it. If we put the good edges up and we don't have them on either side, the next step is to put the edges on the first layer. We can find them on the first layer by rotating a cube. For example, this. What about this edge? In fact, you can very easily make it a good edge by simply turning the front face of the cube. This way. In one move, we put it in a good position. And then we know what to do with it. Put it up. By the way, we got one more good edge. Such a bonus. But it may not happen. Almost anything can happen. And when we don't have any more good edges on the second layer, and we don't have any edges on the first layer, we move on to those on the third. And here we have this. And we can also make this edge good in one turn. Front face can make it good on the left, or vice versa, good on the right. And you already know what to do with these two. Here the place is occupied, make room and put. Consider another situation where we have an edge at the third layer. But if we try to put it in a convenient position, we will destroy what is already solved on a top face. In this case, we need to make sure that there is no occupied slot over this edge. There should be free space right above this edge. To do this, we turn the top face clockwise. And now it's free. And then this edge easily becomes good. And then we know what to do with it. Another possible situation is that there are no edges on any of the layers. There are no edges in a good position either on the second layer, on the third, and on the first. This means that edges are on the bottom face of the cube. But don't forget that the white side has to look up. We can only look down and fix with our finger the place where the white edge is, and then return the cube white face up. Now we know where we have a white edge at the bottom. Turn the cube so that it is on the bottom face in front of us. Now all you have to do is make room for it above it. If it's here, you have to make room here. It's white, we turn it until it's free. Okay, no white, so we can put this part up. Like this. Turn the front face two times clockwise. Front face clockwise two times. We reviewed all situations and now our cross is solved. But remember, we have to make it right by combining all edges in color with adjacent centers. To do this, you just need to turn the top face until we combine as many parts as possible. There may be a situation when we have at some point all parts of the cross in place. Only in this case the cross is considered correct, and on this we finish this stage. But there are other situations. For example, here's one of them. We turn the face, but not all the colors match. If there is only one detail right, this is not enough. We need to keep turning the side until we get at least two parts right. Here we have two details coincided, red and white. They can have different colors. In my case, this. These two parts don't match. The next situation, when we are turning and we have the same two parts, but no longer next to each other, as in this case, but one opposite the other. In order to make the right cross in such situation, you need to learn one easy algorithm. First, consider the situation where we have two neighboring edges on the neighboring sides. For example, one is at the front and the other on the left. That means the back and right edges have to be swept. For example, here we have orange to go to the orange center and green to the green center. To do this, you need to make the following algorithm. Keep the cube salt side to yourself and make the following moves. The right face clockwise, the top clockwise, right counterclockwise, then top counterclockwise, and the right clockwise. If you have done everything correctly, all edges will be in their place. The second situation requires a very similar algorithm. In this case, we should hold the cube in front of us so that the salt edges are in front of us. And accordingly, behind the cube, we are going to work with the right and left edges. In my case, the blue goes to the blue center and the green goes to the green. And the algorithm will be very similar. We raise the right face, then turn the top side not once, but twice. Lower the right face backwards, turn the top face again two times but counterclockwise, and raise the right face. As you can see, the cross is solved. Take your cube in hand and make sure your cross is solved correctly. That is, all four edges stand right up and all of them are the same color as the neighboring centers. This is the first part of the training. If you got it all worked out, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. And if something is wrong, you can always rewatch this video again. And if you're doing well, the best way to thank me is to become my sponsor. That's all for now. See you in the next part of my tutorial.